Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
This type of pattern, this time of year, you can use the visible satellite to pretty much tell the story here. Lots of sunshine with the exception of around the coast. This morning we had fog in the Salinas Valley clearing off nicely. Still a little bit of it lapping at our shores, and that allows for this variation in temperatures. Lows pretty much 40s and 50s, highs in the 80s up Boulder Creek, Bed Lomond, 73 in Santa Cruz. Same yesterday in Watsonville, it was today, 68. Cool on the peninsula, though, with fog all day long. PG, 60 degrees. That was up from 59 last night, yesterday. Seaside, 60. Got up 64 in Monterey and Carmel. 77, though, in Carmel Valley, which was actually warmer than Salinas, but Soledad tied it up. 84 made it in King City, and the hot spot, Morgan Hill, 91. About 10 degrees cooler in Hollister, so there you go, variation on a summer's theme. Lots of 90s out in the Central Valley, the triple digits. For now, anyway, out in the deserts, 83 Van Nuys, 73 at LAX, so a nice mix around the state. To the north, cool in Seattle, warm in Boise, and in Denver, hotter than a blazes in Dallas again. Oh, a month and a half, practically. St. Louis, 94, 83 in New York. It's pretty hot and sticky, and there's some thunderstorms rumbling across the map, and we're getting tornado warnings up Montana and Wyoming, out into the plains of Colorado. Severe thunderstorms here and there. Some pretty good lightning in Florida. They've got more lightning rods than any other state. One twister in Montana. No damage out there. For the rest, it's reports of wind and hail starting to wrap in there to the Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma. More cells tomorrow heading for St. Louis all the way down into the Tennessee Valley. Upper level trough. Active weather in the northeast and around Florida, and a weak trough out in the Pacific Northwest, but won't have much with it. That shows up right here in the water vapor, low pressure going in just north of Vancouver Island. Another weak upper level low. Now the moisture is pretty much getting down to water vapor, no clouds out of that. So the marine layer may just hang about where it is right now, about 1,500 feet for another day. And then tomorrow night it lifts up even a little bit farther, so it'll go farther in, which means less clearing along the coast. Other than that, though, without any big changes upstairs in the atmosphere, we're not looking at a lot of variation in the temperatures, only a degree or two from day to day. And that still is pretty comfortable for summer. 50s are plenty for the morning, and we'll do 70s and 80s once you get into the warmer valleys. And we'll go anywhere from 70 in Salinas to about 15 degrees warmer in King City, with a few 90s in Bradley and San Ardo and farther south toward Paso. But it's about 30 degrees cooler than that on average around the peninsula. This is typically the case this time of year. 60s, 70s for the valleys. North end of the bay, we'll try to squeeze out low 70s around the Santa Cruz, Capitola area, and a few 80s up in the mountains. With the coastal low clouds slipping inland during the night, it'll do it quietly, no worries. Mostly cloudy, afternoon clearing for most, with a little local peninsula fog and a southwesterly wind tomorrow, then back to the northwest the following day. And that means inland plenty of sunshine, but around parts of the bay it may not clear. And not much point in changing the temperatures all that much. Like I say, mostly mid-70s to upper 80s for most of where most of us live. And a few 60s and 70s along the coast and the pinnacles and a couple of places will be warmer than that. But all told, it's about where it should be for August this time of year. Just a little cooler than it could be in the valleys, but not a lot of complaints yet.
No.
Nobody seems happy with that.
Yeah. Well, so, what's not to be happy with? All right.